Experiment 30 deals with enzymes, nature's catalysts. Let's have a look at the Prelab review page. Question number one, specific safety alerts. Look for the triangle icon. Number two, disposal directions. Look for the garbage can icon. And then several questions that are based upon the reading, the introduction to the experiment. None of these are too difficult. Number 10 says, what observation is used to detect the activity of catalase? Well, the answer is the evolution of oxygen gas. That means that you'll see a bubbling or a fizzing in the photos. And here we are. We're ready for the data and report sheets. Part A deals with the preparation of cheese, and you're weighing beakers and cheese curd. You can record to three decimal places. You can get that information from the photos. And when it comes over to calculating the percent yield, I would like you to present that number in three significant figures. So up here, three decimal places, but over here I've changed the terminology a little bit, three significant figures. So be careful with that step. In part B, we're looking at lipid digestion and using milk with some added litmus. And litmus, you know, is an indicator, so it's going to be able to detect acid-base conditions. And you'll be concerned with colors. So record your colors here as observations. In part C, protein digestion. The standard in this case is gelatin plus water. Gelatin has protein in it, and when you mix gelatin with protein, it sets up, much like Jell-O would, into a semi-solid. And if that protein is denatured or destroyed, then that means that it's not going to gel nearly as efficiently. And so over here on the right hand side, you'll be recording extent of gelation and using terms like complete gelation or some or slight. That would be great. Part D, sucrose digestion. Well, you know that sucrose is comprised of fructose and glucose. And so if sucrose is broken apart, you'd get those two monosaccharides, either of which can give a positive Benedict's test, which is a red-brown precipitate. So that's what you'll be looking for in those photos. Part E deals with the hydrolysis of urea. And when urea is hydrolyzed, it releases ammonia. Ammonia is basic. It's going to interact with the indicator and give you a color change. Part F, catalase from potatoes. A potato that has catalase in it can break apart H2O2. The products are water and oxygen gas. And so as that gas is released, you'll see a bubbling or fizzing. So that's what you'd look for there. Questions? Well, they're pretty straightforward. I don't think you'll have any difficulty with these. And down here, number four, I've made a comment for you. It says, suppose in part E, a student gets a red solution with the phenyl red indicator. Which of the following would explain this result? And as I looked at the responses, I realized that A and B are just opposites of one another. A has an acid and B is treating it with a base. So because they're opposites, chances are one of those two, A or B, is correct. I'll let you decide which one is correct. Then finally, number five says in part F, you notice the evolution of a gas. What was the gas? And I've mentioned it a time or two. You can go back to the pre-lab review question and the answer is there. So I hope you have fun with this experiment. And remember to give me an email or a call if I can be of help.